So, with the WGA getting pretty much most of what they want, but not everything, because there are some situations, apparently, that will not go in their favor. You know, let's be honest. You know, they're getting what they want, but maybe, but basically they had to come to a compromise, as pretty much everybody figured they might have to when it comes to negotiating. But the question is, as I've asked before, who really won? Who really won and all that? And we may never know. We may never know and all that of who actually won in the end. But now the question is, can SAG-AFTRA, if you will, the Screen Actors Guild, get something accomplished by tomorrow? Now, apparently reports are saying things are very optimistic that something will get done. But the question is, will they get what they want more so than the Writers Guild? Like, will they have more of what they've been asking for, or will they have to basically be, you know, right in the middle with the, you know, the AMPTP, you know, in the Hollywood, in the studios? Are they going to have to meet right in the middle where it's like, well, we got what we wanted, but not entirely? You know, is that, excuse me, is that going to be the situation? You know, we don't know. Because a lot of people have said that the Screen Actors Guild, you know, is going to probably be the one out of both these strikes that gets a majority of what they're asking for. And that might happen. That might happen, but we'll have to see. Again, things, according to sources, very reliable sources, things look to be optimistic for the SGA. However, we've heard about that before, and sometimes when it looks optimistic, that's when it goes straight downhill. Now, I don't think the Screen Actors Guild is going to want to keep going with this for much longer. I mean, yes, the weather is going to get cooler. We're just in pretty much the final phase of summer, even though it's fall, you know, with the hot weather. But still, we'll have to see if they get what they want. You know, I'm not saying they don't deserve what they're asking for. They do, especially those that are just, you know, brought in for cameos and everything, or background, you know, roles and everything, you know, extra roles and stuff like that. You know, I'm not saying that those people, more so than anything, don't deserve what's coming to them, you know, but the question is, are they going to get everything they want? You know, that's the question. You know, one could probably assume that it's going to be similar in, you know, similar in presentation to what was, you know, to what was agreed upon between the WGA and the studios and the AMPTP. People would assume it's going to be very similar in presentation, to where, you know, the SGA will get what they want. You know, they'll get a majority of what they're asking for, but they're also going to have to meet in the middle about certain things. Like, of course, one of the sticking points is AI. My assumption is probably what's going to happen is that studios will still want to use AI, you know, for certain people, but only on the condition that even if it's a person that's hired for extra background or whatever, that they get a decent percentage financially of the likeness always being used. That's one of the things I could see probably happening. And the same with the major actors and actresses too. That if they have to be utilized in AI, let's say they're off doing another project, but they're needed for a certain scene that's very important, then they too need to be compensated. Like, okay, fine, you could use it, but you got to compensate me, you know, with a good amount, like an equal amount of what you would pay me if I was there. Just saying. You know, you could see things like that. And especially, and also, what about the actors and actresses that are no longer with us? You know, what about them? Well, the families obviously are going to want some residuals out of that. So my thought is, if an actor or actress from the past that's no longer with us is basically written in to appear in some capacity, that the families have to be compensated in a big, big way. In other words, be paid the amount that the actor or actress would be paid if they were there, but probably double that. That's the only thing I can think of, you know, when it comes to that sticking point. But a lot of people are feeling that not only will the SGA get what they want, but it'll probably be along the lines, if not more, than what the WGA agreed to have or agreed to work with over the next 3 years. So the question is, will a deal be made? Will negotiations come to be, you know, will a negotiation, you know, come to be? Will we finally see an end of this tomorrow on October 9th? Or is this going to continue to the end of the year and into 2024? We shall see. But let me know what your thoughts are, guys. Comment down below, live chat during the premiere, and I will talk to you all later.